In this illustration, we'll analyze the changing frequency of a sonometer wire. We are given that a straight sonometer wire is stretched by a weight of solid hanging block. And when oscillating the complete wire, its oscillating frequency is n. And when the block is immersed in water, its frequency is n1. And when immersed in another liquid, its frequency becomes n2. We are required to find the specific gravity of block and that of liquid by using these data. Now, in this situation, we know well, when a sonometer wire oscillates, then for complete oscillations, you can write for complete string oscillation, fundamental frequency of wire is, this we can write n, which is 1 by 2l root of t by mu, and tension in the string will be mg by mu, where mu can be taken as mass per unit length of the string. Say this is our first equation. And we can also write when block is immersed in water, the string tension becomes, we already studied that the effective weight of block when immersed in water can be given as mg 1 minus rho of water by rho of solid. So, using this value, the new frequency will become, the new oscillation frequency is, we are given that this changes to n1. The value of n1 is 1 by 2l root of, the tension will change to mg multiplied by 1 minus rho of water upon rho of solid divided by mu. So, this is our equation 2. And now, when block is immersed in liquid, of which the density we consider as rho L, the tension in a string becomes similar to this value, the effective weight changes to mg 1 minus rho of liquid by rho of solid. So, the oscillation frequency now is, this changes to n2, which we write as 1 by 2l root of mg 1 minus rho l upon rho s divided by mu. This is our equation 3. Now, from these relations, we can analyze. We are required to find the specific gravity of block as well as that of liquid. So, here first we can calculate from equations 1 and 2. Here you can see from 1 and 2 we are getting n1 is equals to n multiplied by root of 1 minus rho of water upon rho of solid, which if we square, this gives n1 square by n square is equals to 1 minus rho of water by rho of solid. And this will result rho of solid by rho of water is the specific gravity of liquid. So, we can write directly rho s by rho w is equals to n square by n square minus n1 square. This is one answer of this problem, which is the specific gravity of block. And similarly, we continue in the same relation from equations 1 and 3, then from 1 and 3 here we can see the value of n2 we are getting is equals to n multiplied by root of 1 minus rho of liquid upon rho of solid. So, squaring this gives us n2 square upon n square is equal to, this value is 1 minus rho L square upon rho S square. So the value of rho s we can substitute from here also. And after simplifying this, we get rho of liquid upon rho of water. You can substitute the value of rho s from here and simplify this relation to get it as n square minus n2 square divided by n square minus n1 square. This is another result of this problem, which is the specific gravity of liquid.